the Brooklyn Bridge. I'm trying to get in to see some exhibitions, but it appears we've got a protest happening here. So they've shut down the bridge to all oncoming traffic.
Honestly, if you don't want to wait, you could go down and come down to Washington Street and come up this side.
Okay, as I understand it, this is a protest about climate change. Don't frack our future. Okay. Once James Kalm again, the bike, and we are at the Derek Eller Gallery. There's the artist. Peter Linde Busk, but he said he has nothing to say, so we'll go through and make a view, or take a view of the show. Well, I got delayed on the bridge because of protesters. Mostly they were protesting Governor Cuomo, but I made it. Let's start out looking at this piece. This is called Distant. Okay, the title of the show is The Generous Gambler, and it says here in the press release that Peter is a Danish artist working in mosaic and collage and using a vast array of recycled materials. Okay, yeah, all right. Well, I like it. I worked in mosaics for about 20 years myself, and looks like Peter's got a nice touch. This piece is 80 by 59 inches, so we're talking about 6.5 by 5 feet. And so he also looks like he's got seashells, various kinds of ceramic things. It's titled, One Cannot Be Betrayed If One Has No People. Well, I walked in initially and was looking at this and thinking, this looks like fabric. But then I got up and looked closer and broke one of my other rules. I read the press release before I started videoing. And I think the larger pieces are even more impressive. Titled The Generous Gambler. What do you think of the work?
Oh, it's amazing. I mean, this stuff is absolutely incredible. I mean, the detail is absolutely...
Oh, Jesus, got pieces of cardboard in there.
I know, is that incredible? It's fantastic.
Okay. Okay, this is fired and glazed ceramics, various kinds of treated paper, various kinds of treated wood, wood stain, shellac, cardboard, card foam on board. And yeah, some of the color things are really brilliant. I like that. Also, yeah, it's cool to see the various levels of the planes that he's laying his mosaics on. And, well, I assume that he makes the main figures and designs them, fires them, glazes them, and then maybe he's a little more eclectic, kind of gathering the pieces that he fills in the mosaics with. In La Mancha 3, 2019, plaster, various kinds of treated wood, fired and glazed ceramic, reconditioned copper and steel etching plates, copper leaf, wood stains, natural stones, colored glass, shellac, printing ink, oxides, porcelain earth on board. Okay. Oh, there's the copper. Also mentioned in the press release some of his influences. Talk about Byzantine mosaics, but they also mention art brut. And I was thinking that yeah, the palette of this kind of makes me think of some of the early Dubuffets from the late 1940s, early 50s. Maybe some of the Corpse de la Dama series. And even I shall be the same to you as you will be to the same to me, 2019. Looks like he's got wood blocks. He may have done some printing with and then recycled. Stones, it's kind of rolled up pieces of cardboard. Oh, I like the way that he's able to use the various kinds of materials and kind of repeat certain motifs to get into a pattern. Suddenly the gallery filled up. It's like 5 minutes before closing. This is a nice piece. One Flew Over the Cuckoo's Nest. 2019, reconditioned copper etching plates, various kinds of treated wood, natural stones, fired and glazed ceramics, porcelain, gold leaf, wood print on copper, printing ink, cardboard, white, gesso, various prints on paper, linen, natural stones, plaster, terra, pozzolano oxide copperleaf on board. Well, I think I like this one because you really have got a contrast between the central figure and the ground. I like the herringbone tweed pattern. I'm sure that Peter's studio would be very interesting. He's probably got boxes, maybe crates full of various kinds of stones, mosaics, glass, shards of different materials, marble, alabaster. Excuse me, I gotta get a picture of this one too. Okay. This is Old England, My Lionheart, 2019. 53 by 41 inches. James Kalm reporting on Peter Linde Busk, the generous gambler, here at Derek Eller, 300 Broome Street on the Lower East Side. You can like this. Share, subscribe, recommend it to your friends, link it, and you can leave your thoughts, ideas, comments, criticisms, and reviews below. And we only ask you to say thank you, Kate. Oh, thank you. Thank you. That was great.